In our today's lecture, we will be studying about the muscles of upper limb. And starting from the muscle of the scapular region, we will first talk about TD's major muscle. So basically, as you can see, this muscle is arising from the posterior surface of the inferior scapular angle. This is the region of TD's major muscle. As you can see, it is arising from the inferior angle and the lower part of the lateral border of the scapula, which is your wing bone, and it's inserting on the humerus, which is basically the intertubercular sulcus of the humerus. The major function of this muscle is to adduct and to medially rotate the humerus, which is your arm. So this muscle will be responsible for the medial rotation and adduction of the arm. It also helps in stabilization of the scapula. This is another image showing the TD's major muscle, and let's revise it again. First we will start with the region of TD's major muscle. The region of the TD's major muscle, as I have already discussed, it is the inferior angle and the lower part of the lateral border of the scapula, and it inserts onto the humerus on the intertubercular sulcus. The main function of this muscle is to adduct and medially rotate the humerus, but it also assists in the extension of the arm, and it stabilizes the scapula as well. Now we will talk about the rotator cuff muscles, a very important group of muscles. This group of muscle basically is composed of four muscles: subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor muscle. So to remember this muscle group, you can remember a mnemonic, SITS. S stands for subscapularis, I for infraspinatus, T for teres minor, and S for supraspinatus muscle. So we will first start with the teres minor muscle. As you can see that there are four muscle groups. There are four muscles, a group of four muscles, and these muscles are highlighted with different colors. So starting with the teres minor, this muscle is highlighted with yellow color, and the region of this muscle is the lateral border of the scapula, and its insertion is onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. As you can see here, it's inserting onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. The function of this muscle is to laterally rotate the arm, and as well as the stabilization of the humerus as a part of the rotator cuff muscle. The next muscle which we are going to discuss is the infraspinatus muscle. And this muscle is basically, in this image, it is highlighted with blue color. And as you can see, it is located on the large posterior part of the infraspinous fossa. And the insertion of this muscle is onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, just like the teres minor muscle. That was also inserting onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. So the insertion of the infraspinatus muscle is also onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. The function of this muscle is to laterally rotate the arm, and as a part of the rotator cuff muscle, it also stabilizes the shoulder joint. The function of teres minor muscle was also to laterally rotate the arm, so its function is same as the teres minor muscle. The next muscle that we are going to discuss is the supraspinatus muscle, and you can see that this muscle is highlighted with red color. This muscle is basically deep, and it originates from the supraspinous fossa, and this is also located on the posterior superior portion of the scapula, as you can see. The origin of this muscle is basically from the supraspinous fossa of the scapula, and the insertion of this muscle is onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, just like the other two muscles that we have previously discussed. This muscle is also has its insertion onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. The function of this muscle is different. It basically assists in the abduction of the arm, and as a part of the rotator cuff muscle, it stabilizes the humerus. We will revise the rotator cuff muscles again. The first thing is that the rotator cuff muscle is basically a group of four muscles, which includes subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor muscle. This muscle group, these all muscles have one particular function. They all stabilize the shoulder joint. And if we talk about the individual muscle, we will first talk about the teres minor muscle. The teres minor muscle has its origin from the lateral border of the scapula. As you can see, it is highlighted with yellow color in this picture. This is arising from the lateral border of the scapula, and it's inserting onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. Its function is to laterally rotate the arm, and as a part of the rotator cuff muscle, it stabilizes the shoulder joint. The next muscle that we discussed was infraspinatus muscle, and this muscle is highlighted with blue color, and the origin of this muscle is from the infraspinatus fossa of the scapula. We have studied the scapula bone, and we know the parts of this bone. So when I am talking about the infraspinous or supraspinous fossa, I hope that you will remember what I am talking about. So the origin of the infraspinatus muscle is the infraspinous fossa of the scapula, and it's inserting onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, just like the teres minor muscle. So the function of the infraspinatus muscle is same as the teres minor muscle. It also laterally rotate the arm and stabilizes the humerus as a part of the rotator cuff muscle. The next muscle that we are going to discuss is the supraspinatus muscle, and just like its name, it will arise from the supraspinous fossa of the scapula, and this muscle in this image is highlighted with red color. The supraspinatus muscle basically originates from the supraspinous fossa, and it inserts onto the greater tubercle of the humerus. The function of this muscle is to assist in the abduction of the arm, and as a part of the rotator cuff muscle, it stabilizes the humerus. The next muscle is the subscapularis muscle, which is highlighted in green color, and this is also a muscle of the rotator cuff muscle. So this muscle arises from the subscapular fossa, and the insertion of this muscle is onto the lesser tubercle of the humerus. So the rest of the three muscles were inserting onto the greater tubercle of the humerus, but this is the muscle which inserts onto the lesser tubercle of the humerus. The function of this muscle is to medially rotate the arm. This is the only muscle which is medially rotating the arm in the rotator cuff muscle. So this muscle is medially rotating the arm, and as a part of the rotator cuff muscle, it will also stabilize the humerus. So that's all about the rotator cuff muscles. The next muscle that we are going to talk about is the serratus anterior, and we have previously discussed about it. This muscle is named due to its interior digitations that have serrated or finger-like appearance, and this muscle arises from the 1 to 8 ribs, and sometimes it originates from the ninth rib as well, and the insertion of this muscle is onto the medial part of the interior border of the scapula, or you can remember it as the medial border of the scapula. So it originates from the lateral parts of the 1st to 8th rib typically, and sometimes it can originate from the 9th rib as well. The insertion of this muscle is onto the medial border of the scapula, and the function of this muscle is to protract and rotate the scapula. So this muscle is responsible for the protraction and rotation of the scapula. Okay, so this muscle is basically called the levator scapular muscle. And this muscle originates from the transverse processes of the atlas and axis, as you can see here. This muscle is originating from the transverse processes of the atlas and axis, which is C1 and C2 vertebrae, and from the posterior tubercles of the C3 and C4. Here you can clearly see the origin of this muscle from the C1, C2, C3 and C4 vertebra. It basically arises from the transfer processes of the atlas and axis, which is C1 and C2 vertebra, and from the posterior tubercles of the C3 and C4. The insertion of this muscle is onto the posterior surface of the medial scapular border, as you can see here. It's inserting onto the posterior surface of the medial scapular border. This is the medial border of the scapula. The function of this muscle is to elevate the scapula. So that's all for today. We have so far studied about the muscles of the scapular region and the muscles of arm, which include the rotator cuff muscles, and we also studied about the serratus anterior and the levator scapular muscle. So that's all for today, and if you have any question regarding this, you can ask. Thank you so much.